blessings upon us tonight. Pray your blessings upon these that will sing, those that will have a part in the program. Give to them that which is from heaven, that they might impart to us a new sense of patriotism, a new sense of love for America and love for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Bless, we pray, the visitors, the members, and all of the people that have come tonight. We'll look to you and love you and thank you in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. It's my pleasure to introduce to you tonight the choir of the Calvary Baptist Church under the direction of Larry Brundige. And in turn, I think Ken Lilly will do the directing tonight and Larry will do the narrating. But nevertheless, the choir of the Calvary Baptist Church presenting to you a musical entitled Liberty.
Course of human events, it becomes necessary for one people to dissolve the political bands which have connected them with another, and to assume among the powers of the earth the separate and equal station to which the laws of nature and nature's God entitle them. They should declare the causes which compel them to the separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. We therefore do solemnly publish and declare that these colonies are and of right ought to be free and independent states. And for the support of this declaration, we mutually pledge to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor.
Thank you.
On a hot summer's morning in July 1776, a group of 55 men met in a Philadelphia courtroom. They were just ordinary men from various walks of life, but they all shared a common dream: to win for their children and their children's children the glorious prize of freedom. On that day, an infant republic dared to defy the might of a great empire, and the American Revolution fanned into a flame which could not be snuffed out. A song was born in the hearts of those new Americans, a song we're still singing, and it rings with the joy of freedom. Just pride of patriotism, filling our music with echoes of the past and sounds of hope for our future. One of the most beautiful of all American songs was written by an English teacher as she sat viewing the world from the highest mountain peak in Colorado. Surrounded by the grandeur of jagged mountain peaks and the beauty of spacious skies, Catherine Lee Bates offered to our nation these immortal words.
Majesty. Arkansas, California, Colorado, and Connecticut, and more. Delaware, Florida, Georgia, then Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, still 35 to go. Kansas and Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, and good old Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, and Montana, then Nebraska's 27, number 28's Nevada. And New Jersey and way down New Mexico. There's New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, now let's see, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, and there's Utah, Vermont, I'm almost through, Virginia, then there's Washington and West Virginia too. Could Wisconsin be the last one, or is that 49? No, Wyoming is the last state in the 50 states that rhyme. California, Colorado, and Connecticut, and more. Delaware, Florida, Georgia, then Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, still 35 to go. Kansas and Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, and good old Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, and Montana, then Nebraska, 27, number 28, Nevada. There's New Hampshire and New Jersey, and way down New Mexico. There's New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, now let's see, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, and there's Utah, Vermont, I'm almost through. Virginia, then there's Washington and West Virginia too. Could Wisconsin be the last one, or is that 49? No, Wyoming is the last state in the 50 states that rhyme.
Music has long been the language of the heart, the true expression of the people. We pass it down year after year, note by note, and generation to generation. And then a remarkable phenomenon occurs. These simple homemade hand-me-downs emerge from relative obscurity and step into the bright light of fame we know as folk songs. Join us on a nostalgic trip across the country, east to west, north to south, and sing along with the music of America.
Thank you.
Rising majestically from New York Harbor is the colossal copper statue of a lady. In her right hand, she holds aloft a flaming torch, a flame shining with such brilliance, it's a beacon of hope to the farthest corners of the earth. The lady's name is Liberty. Casting a sense of sudden greatness on all who behold her, this tall and beautiful sculpture stands draped in the noble dreams of free hearts everywhere. Her enormous expression is not one of force, but of freedom. Not one of power, but of love. For somehow when we gaze into her eyes, she makes us feel the magnificence of being human. For over 100 years, this stirring symbol has graced the gateway to our home, endearing herself warmly into our hearts, ever reminding us of the very essence of our country to which we owe our allegiance. Shine far, dear lady, shine free forever.
Brazen giant of Greek fame, with conquering limbs astride from land to land. Here at our sea-washed sunset gates shall stand a mighty woman with a torch, whose flame is the imprisoned lightning, and her name, Mother of Exiles. From her beaconed hand glows worldwide welcome. Her mild eyes command the air-bridged harbor that Twin Cities frame. Keep, ancient lands, your storied pomp, cries she with silent lips. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed, to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
Celebrate the joy of our freedom without remembering the great price paid for that freedom. When we consider the untold numbers of men and women who chose to set aside their personal ambitions and dreams to assure the well-being of our nation, we stagger at the eternal debt we owe. We are indeed the beneficiaries of those who have made and will continue to make tremendous sacrifices for the advancement and surety of our liberty.
There I sat on buttermilk hill. Who could blame me, cry my fill, and every tear would turn. Gone for a soldier.
larger sense. We cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or distract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave their last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that the government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from this earth.
Thank you.
Over 200 years have passed since the birth of our nation. We find the world is very different now. And yet, as John Kennedy so clearly reminded us, those same revolutionary beliefs for which our forebears fought are still at issue around the globe. The belief that the rights of man come not from the generosity of the state, but from the hand of God. We dare not forget that we are heirs of that first revolution. Let the word go forth from this time and place to friend and foe that the torch has been passed to a new generation of Americans, born in this country, tempered by war, disciplined by a hard and bitter peace, proud of our ancient heritage, and unwilling to witness or permit the slow undoing of those human rights to which this nation has always been committed. Let every nation know, whether it wishes us well or ill, that we shall pay any price, bear any burden, meet any hardship, support any friend, oppose any foe, to assure the survival and success of liberty. This much we pledge, and more. Today, as we reflect on the blessings of our liberty, we pause to ask your help. We may be faithful stewards of the freedom we've been granted. We remember your sobering words from Scripture, that to whom much is given, shall much be required. We echo the prayer in President Reagan's inaugural address, that you would continue to hold us close as we fill the world with our song, a song of unity, affection, and love. May we remain one people under God, dedicated to the dream of freedom that you have placed in the human heart. Amen. Let us go forth to lead the land that we love, asking God's blessing and his help, but knowing that God's work must truly be our own. May God bless you, and may God bless America.
Great. All the people said what? Amen. Thank God for America. Larry? Thank you, sir. Ken Lilly? And the choir. Man, you've done a great job. Behind the screen is Emil Balliot. He gave you all those pictures. And without which we could not operate, Sam Williams and Charles Bowen up in the balcony. And I have no idea who's on the floodlights. Who? Jerry Warren, Juarez, and Doyle Dunning. Well, that's a pretty good crowd. And the cue card operators down here at the front. Miss Playhot and Miss Balliot. And the musicians. Where are they? Renee and Tawana. Okay. Man, that's great. And my thanks to them and to you for coming. And let's stand together. Tomorrow night, we'll redo this at 7 o'clock. And it'll be worth your seeing twice. In fact, Dennis, I missed three-fourths of those slides trying to look at something else. So I need to come back. By the way, did you recognize the fellows in the pictures? Some of them, the names you got, and the others, the names got lost in the crowd up here in New York. But anyhow, they were all there. We're glad you were here tonight. We welcome you back tomorrow night in the morning if you'd like to come. But we certainly want you to be back tomorrow night at 7 o'clock for a representation of this. Tremendous. I think I could use it every day. It'll help your patriotism, make you a better American. Father, thank you again for your blessings. Thank you for tonight and all it means to our hearts and lives. Thank you for giving us freedom and liberty in America. And thank you for the liberty that we have in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.